हेलो ज्ञान स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द सोशल साइंस क्लास अबाउट इंपॉर्टेंट डायनास्टीज ऑफ नॉर्थ इंडिया. इन दिस चैप्टर चिल्ड्रन यू आर ऑल गोइंग टू स्टडी. द लर्निंग पॉइंट्स आर इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट मौर्य डायनास्टी एंड इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट गुप्ता डायनास्टी. फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम इन इंडियन हिस्ट्री बाय द 4th century BCE, ए लार्ज एम्पायर वॉज बिल्ट इन इंडिया अंडर द मौर्यास. द मौर्यन एम्पायर politically unified a large part of the country. The two main sources of information on the Mauryan period are Indica by Megasthenes and Arthashastra by Chanakya. The rock and pillar edicts of Ashoka provide valuable information as well. The first king of the Mauryan dynasty was Chandragupta Maurya. In 322 BCE, he overthrew the last Nanda king Dhananda and seized the throne of Magadha. Chandragupta Maurya's success was due to his advisor Chanakya or Kautilya, who was a wise Brahmana scholar. Chandragupta Maurya freed northwestern India from Greek control. Chandragupta Maurya was an able and ambitious ruler. He built a vast empire stretching from Hindu Kush in the west to Bengal in the east and from the Himalayas in the north to Narmada in the south. Chandragupta Maurya was succeeded by his son Bindusara. During his reign, Bindusara expanded the empire up to Mysore. He was succeeded by his son Ashoka. Ashoka ascended the throne in 273 BCE. He is the first king to give welfare of subjects as his top priority by declaring, "My citizens are like my children." At that time, a powerful kingdom, Kalinga, was not under Mauryan control. Kalinga controlled the land and sea routes to South India and Southeast Asia. Ashoka attacked Kalinga in 261 BCE and conquered it after a bitter struggle. The Mauryan Empire reached the height of its political power during Ashoka's rule. It stretched from the Hindu Kush in the west to Brahmaputra in the east and from the Himalayas in the north to Mysore in the south. It also included Kabul, Kandahar, Nepal and Kashmir. The Kalinga War, however, became a turning point in Ashoka's life. The death and destruction in this war filled him with remorse. Deeply influenced by the Buddhist teachings of peace, non-violence, and compassion, Ashoka embraced Buddhism and devoted his life to the welfare of his subjects. Ashoka replaced the policy of Digvijaya with Dhamma Vijaya. Dhamma is derived from the Sanskrit word Dhamma, meaning religious duty. The main principles of Dhamma were: people should live in a peace and harmony, ahimsa or non-violence, and non-injury to all living creatures should be followed by all. People should love one another and respect other religions. Children should obey their elders, and the elders should treat the children with understanding. Ashoka dedicated the rest of his life to spreading the message of Buddha. Ashoka constructed many Buddhist monasteries and stupas throughout the kingdom. Ashoka sent learned scholars to distant lands to spread Buddhism. He sent his son Mahendra and daughter Sangamitra to Sri Lanka to spread Buddhism. Ashoka organized the third Buddhist council at Pataliputra to discuss ways of propagating Buddhism. Edicts are royal commands or proclamations. They were inscribed on rocks, published stone pillars and caves. Ashokan edicts are a valuable source of information about the Mauryan period. The supreme power was held by the king. He was advised by a council of ministers called the Mantri Parishad. The empire was divided into provinces. The provinces were divided into nagaras or towns and gramas or villages. The capital city of the Mauryan Empire was Pataliputra. There was an elaborate spy system which informed the king of the happenings inside and outside the kingdom. The Mauryan kings had a large well-equipped standing army which included infantry, cavalry, chariots and a navy. The Mauryan period was an age of cultural brilliance. The artistic achievements of this period can be seen in the numerous stupas, monolithic pillars, caves and sculpted figures of the Ashokan period. Some of the more famous works of art include the stupa at Sanchi and the Saranath pillar with the lion capital. Some of these symbols have now been adopted by India and can be found on the flag and currency notes. The Mauryan rulers unified the country and brought peace and stability. These favorable conditions promoted the growth of the economy and made the empire rich and prosperous. Agriculture was the main occupation of the Mauryas. Trade and commerce flourished. Overseas trade was carried on with Sri Lanka, Egypt and Greece. The death of Ashoka in 232 BCE marked the beginning of the decline of the Mauryan Empire. After Ashoka, his successors were weak and ineffective. The last Mauryan emperor, Brihadratha, was killed by Pushyamitra Sangha, the founder of the Sangha dynasty. This brought an end to the rule of one of the most glorious dynasties in the history of ancient India. Now let us learn about the Gupta dynasty. After Mauryas, Guptas ruled India. Gupta dynasty is a prominent one in the history of India. Guptas from 322 650 CE on the ruin of Shatavahana and Kushan Empire rose the Gupta Empire. Founder of Gupta dynasty was Sri Gupta. First important king of the Gupta dynasty was Chandragupta I. He married from Lichavi princess from Nepal, which strengthened his political position. The Chandragupta I ruler of considerable importance because he started the Gupta era in AD 319-20, which marked the date of his accession. Later, many inscriptions came to be dated in the Gupta era. Samudragupta from 335-380 CE. The Gupta kingdom was enlarged enormously by Chandragupta I's son and successor Samudragupta. His court poet Harisena wrote a glowing account of the military exploits of his patron. The inscription is engraved at Allahabad on the same pillar as the one that carries an inscription of the peace-loving Ashoka. The Allahabad pillar inscription contains a long list of states, kings and tribes which were conquered and brought under various degrees of subjugation. After these military victories, Samudragupta performed the Ashwamedha sacrifice. He issued the golden silver coins with the legends of the restorer of the Ashwamedha. It is because of his military achievements, Samudragupta was hailed as Indian Napoleon by historian Vincent Smith. Samudragupta succeeded by his son Chandragupta II, Vikramaditya. Ruin of Chandragupta II saw the highest peak of the Gupta Empire. Chandragupta II inherited the military genius of his father and extended the Gupta Empire by the judicious combinations of the policy of diplomacy and warfare. Fahe was a Buddhist monk, visited India during the rule of Chandragupta II. He has mentioned his experiences of India in his work Gokoki. According to him, crimes were rare in Gupta Empire and the administration was pro-people. Sanskrit literature grew well during Gupta period. Kalidasa was a major poet of Gupta period. He was one of the Navaratnas present in the court of Chandragupta II. He has written 4 epic poems and 3 dramas. Then Shudraka, who wrote Mrichakatika, and Vishakha Datta wrote Mudrakshasa, and the Panchatantra of Vishnu Sharma belong to this period. And the dictionary by Amarasimha called Amarakosha is an excellent work. During the ruin of Guptas, the temple architecture started. The Sanchi Temple of Madhya Pradesh is an ancient temple of India. Dhamik Stupa, 128 feet tall at Saranath near Varanasi, was built during the times of the Guptas. The paintings of Ajanta Rockout caves are world famous. In science and technology had progressed much during the ruin of Guptas. Aryabhatta, Brahmagupta and Varahamihira were the famous science and mathematicians. Then the metallurgy had achieved great progress during the Gupta period. The iron pillar at Mehroli near Delhi is an example of this progress. Vagabhatta of the Gupta times prepared a summary of the famous work Charaka Samhita, known as Ashtanga Rudaya Samhita. The credit for using mercury as a medicine for the first time goes to doctors of India.
Thank you for watching the video. If you really liked our video, click on the like button, share and do subscribe. From Gnanajyoti team, alone we can do so little, together we can do so much. For further information, kindly visit our website, that is www.gnanajyoti.in.